Hello students, in the last video we had studied about the structure of heart and in this video we will studied about the functioning of heart, how hearts function in our body. We all know that heart beats throughout the life and it is continuous process. One heartbeat consists of rhythmic contraction and relaxation of heart muscle. One heartbeat can be defined as a rhythmic contraction and relaxation of heart muscle. Contraction is also known as systole, and relaxation is termed as diastole. So we can also define heartbeat as a rhythmic systole and diastole of heart muscle. One heartbeat occurs in 0.8 second. This is the time duration of one heartbeat. Okay? It comprises of three phases. One is joint diastole. Another one is atrial systole. And last one is ventricle systole. The heartbeat, which occurs for 0.8 second and comprise of three phases, all these constitute one cardiac cycle. The normal heartbeat that occurs for 0.8 second and it comprise of three different phases, that is joint diastole, atrial systole and ventricle systole. All these comprise one cardiac cycle. Okay, let me study about it. One cardiac cycle can be represented by a diagram like this. In which this phase comprise of joint diastole, it is about 0.4 second. This comprise of atrial systole for 0.1 second, and the last one is ventricular systole that comprise of 0.3 second. How joint diastole occur? Let me study about it. During joint diastole, all four chambers of heart are in relaxed condition. All the four chambers of heart is in relaxed condition, and during which right atrium receive deoxygenated blood carried by vena cava from all over the body parts. At the same time, left atrium also receive oxygenated blood from lungs. This is the condition when both the atrium collects or receive blood from different medium, or we can say different vessels. Right atrium collects deoxygenated blood from the vena cava. Vena cava collects blood from all the tissues all over the body. That is deoxygenated in nature. All the oxygen is used up by the tissue there. And at the same time, left atrium receives blood from the lungs after oxygenation. That means this type of blood is oxygenated blood. The duration of this joint diastole is about 0.4 second. This is very important to know and learn. Second phase arises after that, that is atrial systole. Diastole word is used for relaxation mode of muscles of heart, and systole word is used for the contraction mode of heart muscle. Okay. Now the next phase is atrial systole, in which atrium get contracted, and they after their contraction, both atrium, simultaneously pour their secretion into their respective ventricles. That means right atrium pour deoxygenated blood into right ventricle and left atrium into left atrium pour oxygenated blood into left ventricle. Look at the diagram so that you can easily get this phases. First phase is joint diastole, in which deoxygenated blood from vena cava, these two are vena cava, that collects blood from the upper side of the body and it collects blood from the lower side of the body. Both the vena cava carry deoxygenated blood, and this blood get filled in the right atrium. So at the same time, the oxygenated blood from the lungs enters into the left atrium through the pulmonary vein and get collected in it. This phase is the joint diastole phase, in which all the muscles get in relaxed position. After that, second phase occurs. This phase for the only 0.4 second. Next phase, that is the atrial contraction, occurs. Then after atrial, during the atrial contraction, in the wall of atrium there is a highly specialized muscle cell. That muscle cell is known as natural pacemaker, and the name of this pacemaker is SA node, or we can say sinoatrial node. Okay, these are the group of certain highly specialized muscle cells that generate a electrical impulse or signals, and these signals initiate contraction phase of the atrium wall. When atrium start contraction, then right atrium pour deoxygenated blood into the right ventricle, and similarly left atrium pour secretion into oxygenated blood into the left ventricle. Okay, the blood will come from here into this and from right atrium into right ventricle. Okay, this is the second phase, we call it atrial systole. Atrial systole occurs for only 0.1 second. It is the shortest phase. Next phase is ventricular systole. ventricular cystery in which ventricle starts contraction. What happened during the ventricle contraction? Blood from the right ventricles enters into the pulmonary artery and carried to the lungs for oxygenation. Here the blood is deoxygenated in nature and carried by pulmonary artery towards the lung for oxygenation. At the same time, left ventricle also contracts and pour the blood, oxygenated blood, into the main artery or largest artery of the body, that is aorta. From there, oxygenated blood gets applied to different parts of the body, and this phase is known as ventricular systole. Ventricular systole, during ventricular systole, ventricles contracts, both ventricles contract together and both ventricles relax together. Similarly, both atrium contracts at the same time and relax at the same time. When ventricles contract, right ventricle pour deoxygenated blood into pulmonary artery to pass it to the lungs for oxygenation. At the same time, left ventricle pour oxygenated blood into systemic aorta, that is the largest artery of our body, to supply blood throughout the body. This phase lasts for 0.3 seconds. This phase is of about 0.3 seconds. During the one cardiac cycle, there occurs three phases. How during these three phases blood get passed from one chamber to another chamber? Let me see. During the joint systole, all the chambers are in relaxed condition. In this condition, the atrium are in receiving mode. Both the atrium are in receiving mode and receive the blood. How it receive the blood? Right atrium receive deoxygenated blood from the vena cava, and these vena cava collect deoxygenated blood from different tissues across the body. First of all, during the joint diastole, the blood enters into right atrium, that is deoxygenated in nature. Similarly, at the same time, the pure blood, or we can say oxygenated blood, from the lungs through pulmonary vein enters into the left atrium. So during the joint diastole phase, both atrium get filled with blood. Right one with the deoxygenated blood and left one with the oxygenated blood. This phase occurs for only 0.4 second of duration. Next phase is started when the contraction in the wall of atrium started due to sinoatrial node, or we can say natural pacemaker. This pacemaker is a term used for highly specialized muscle cells situated in the wall of atrium, especially in the right atrium. Okay, when the contraction wave started in the wall of atrium, the blood gets started pouring into the subsequent ventricles. That means right atrium pour the deoxygenated blood into right ventricle through the wall, and this wall is tricuspid valve. And similarly, at the same time, left atrium pour oxygenated blood into the left ventricle through bicuspid or mitral valve. Okay, so this is the second phase of heart functioning, which lasts for only 1 second. It is the shortest phase of blood transferring into the heart. Okay, next, after that, when blood enters into the ventricles, both of the ventricles, due to increased pressure, when the ventricle starts contracting, the pressure increases, and due to increased pressure inside the ventricle, these tricuspid and mitral valve, or we can say bicuspid valve, get closed. And due to this closing of valves, a sound produced, and this sound is known as S1 sound or lub sound. Okay, the sound will produce due to S1 sound is termed for it. S1 sound produced due to closing of tricuspid or tricuspid and mitral, we can also known mitral as bicuspid valve. This tricuspid and bicuspid is situated in between atrium and ventricle at the same time. Okay, so due to the closing of these valves, a sound produced that is known as lub sound. Next, what happened? When the blood enters into ventricle, the third phase, ventricular systole, occurs, in which wall of ventricles start contracting and pushes the and create the pressure inside the blood volume, and which makes the blood volume to push inside the pulmonary artery as well as in the systemic aorta. Okay, right ventricle pour deoxygenated blood into the pulmonary artery. From here, blood passes to the lungs of the both side, and after passing or after reaching to lungs, this oxygenated blood turns into oxygenated blood there, and then again this oxygenated blood enters into the heart through pulmonary veins into the left atrium. But we are talking about the ventricular systole. When the right ventricle contracts, at the same time left ventricle also contract and pour their oxygenated blood into the systemic aorta. Through the systemic aorta, the blood passes to different parts of the body. When the blood passes into this vessels, pulmonary artery and systematic aorta, the ventricle starts again diastole. That means it again goes into relaxation mode and decreases its pressure. But the pressure inside this tube-like structure, that is aorta and pulmonary artery, is much higher than the ventricle. What happens after that? The blood start going from backward direction, but these two walls here, this is the seminal wall present at the bottom of pulmonary artery and aorta. These become closed and prevent the backward flow of blood into the ventricle. This closing of, we can say the closing of these walls, seminal walls of pulmonary artery and aorta, create a sound that is known as dub sound. It is also known as S2 sound, which is produced by the closing of semilunar valves of pulmonary artery and aorta. Okay, these are the two sounds produced during the heartbeat. As we already seen that during one cardiac cycle, blood flows twice through the heart. On the first time, deoxygenated blood from vena cava enters into the right atrium, and in the second time the deoxygenated blood from the lungs enters into the left atrium. It means there occurs two type of circulation here, and such type of circulation is termed as double circulation. Okay, so we can say in human being double circulation occurs. Double circulation in human being comprise of two step. One is pulmonary circulation. Pulmonary circulation, the word pulmonary is termed for the circulation related to lungs. What happened here? From heart, deoxygenated blood carried by pulmonary artery to the lungs, where oxygenation occurs. After oxygenation, oxygenated blood through pulmonary veins come back into left atrium. This is the first circulation, we called it as a pulmonary circulation. Second circulation is systemic circulation. During systematic circulation, heart from its left ventricle passes oxygenated blood through aorta to all body parts, to the different tissue, where most of the oxygen of blood get used up by the tissue for the different metabolic activities. There, when blood returns back, it consists of large amount of carbon dioxide and some nitrogenous waste along it. Their blood becomes deoxygenated, and this deoxygenated blood returns to heart through vena cava and again enters into heart in the right atrium. You can also show double circulation by drawing a simple diagram. You have to make a four-chambered compartment for heart, in which upper two chambers represent atrium and lower two chambers represent ventricle. This is right atrium, left atrium, right ventricle and left ventricle. Okay, above that you have to draw a compartment for lung. Okay, and here you have to draw a compartment for tissues of body parts. How circulation occurs? We know that double circulation comprises of two steps. First is pulmonary circulation and another one is systematic circulation. What happened during the pulmonary circulation? During the pulmonary circulation, right ventricle passes deoxygenated blood. It passes deoxygenated blood through pulmonary artery to the lungs, where oxygenation occurs. And due to this oxygenation, this oxygenated blood turns into oxygenated blood. From lungs, oxygenated blood enters into the left atrium. Oxygenated blood through the pulmonary veins enters into the left atrium. This phase comprises of pulmonary circulation. What happens during the systematic circulation? During the systematic circulation, from the left ventricle, oxygenated blood passes through aorta to all the tissues of body parts where some metabolic activities occur, and due to this metabolic activities, various waste products generated and these get dissolved into the blood, and oxygen is used up for this metabolic activities inside the tissue of body parts. When the blood comes out from this tissue and collected by different veins, it becomes almost deoxygenated, and this deoxygenated blood carried away by vena cava throughout the different body parts, and through this deoxygenated blood enters into right atrium. What makes the atrium to contract? This is a specialized muscle cells, and these specialized muscle cells is termed as SA node. SA node is specialized muscle cells present in the wall of right atrium that initiate wave of contraction. And for contraction we use it as a system. Okay. What is the full form of SA node? SA full form is sinoatrial, and this node is termed as sinoatrial node because it is present in the wall of atrium. Okay. This sinoatrium naturally contracts and create a wave in the wall of atrium. So it is also termed as natural pacemaker. But due to some disease, or we can say some genetic illness, this node does not work properly and become also functionless at certain cases. What happened in that condition? It is replaced surgically by some artificial pacemaker. Why septum is present? Septum is present between right and left chamber of heart to provide, or we can say to prevent, mixing of oxygenated and deoxygenated blood. This ensures quick and efficient supply of oxygen for energy production . This energy helps to maintain body temperature of warm-blooded animals. Who are warm-blooded animals? Mammals and birds. Birds we can say aves. Okay. These are warm-blooded animals who require to maintain their body temperature. Thus, they need oxygen-rich blood to get supplied into their tissue, from where they release energy. Okay. But in cold-blooded animals, they doesn't require continuous supply of oxygen and continuous supply of energy to maintain their body temperature, because their body temperature differs according to their environment. So they have three-chambered or double-chambered heart. In amphibians and reptiles, they have three-chambered heart in which partial mixing of oxygenated and deoxygenated bloods takes place in the third chamber. And in the two-chambered heart of fishes, the blood directly passes to the gills for oxygenation, and from there oxygenated blood passes to all the body parts.